Christ having risen from the dead dies now no more. Death will no longer have dominion over him. Alleluia.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Christ, having risen from the dead, dies now no more. Death will no longer have dominion over him. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have been renewed by paschal remedies, transcending the likeness of our earthly parentage, may be transformed in the image of our heavenly Maker. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. After their release, Peter and John went back to their own people and reported what the chief priests and elders had told them. And when they heard it, they raised their voices to God with one accord and said, "Sovereign Lord, maker of heaven and earth and the sea and all that is in them, you said by the Holy Spirit, through the mouth of our father David, your servant, why did the Gentiles rage and the peoples entertain folly? The kings of the earth took their stand, and the princes gathered together against the Lord and against his anointed. Indeed, they gathered in this city against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed. Herod and Pontius Pilate, together with the Gentiles and the other peoples of Israel, to do what your hand and your will had long ago planned to take place. And now, Lord, take note of their threats and enable your servants to speak your word with all boldness, as you stretch forth your hand to heal, and signs and wonders are done through the name of your holy servant Jesus. As they prayed, the place where they were gathered shook, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and continued to speak the word of God with boldness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. Why do the nations rage and the peoples utter folly? The kings of the earth rise up and the princes conspire together against the Lord and against his anointed. Let us break their fetters and cast their bonds from us. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. He who is throned in heaven laughs. The Lord derides them. Then in anger he speaks to them. He terrifies them in his wrath. I myself have set up my king on Zion, my holy mountain. I will proclaim the decree of the Lord. Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord. The Lord said to me, "You are my son. This day I have begotten you. Ask of me, and I will give you the nations for an inheritance, and the ends of the earth for your possession. You shall rule them with an iron rod. You shall shatter them like an earthen dish." Blessed are all who take refuge in the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
There was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. He came to Jesus at night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you are doing unless God is with him." Jesus answered and said to him, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless one is born from above, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Nicodemus said to him, "How can a man once grown old be born again? Surely he cannot re-enter his mother's womb and be born again, can he?" Jesus answered, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless one is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. What is born of flesh is flesh, what is born of spirit is spirit. Do not be amazed that I told you, you must be born from above. Wind blows where it wills. You can hear the sound it makes, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We find in today's Gospel Nicodemus, who is a prominent member of the ruling Jewish class, comes to Jesus, but he comes at night. He comes in the darkness. Now, this is important for two reasons. First, he is coming seeking the light. He recognizes that he is in darkness, in ignorance, and he needs to have his questions answered, and that's why he's seeking out Jesus. But he doesn't seek out Jesus during the day, when Jesus is teaching in the temple, when Jesus is out and about. He doesn't seek him then. He's not willing, at least not yet, to be publicly associated with Jesus. And it's a good reminder to all of us. Where is that boldness that we're supposed to have, a boldness we see in the reading from the Acts of the Apostles, that even when they're mistreated by the Sanhedrin, they go out and proclaim more boldly, this is the truth. Jesus is risen. That boldness that comes through the power of the Holy Spirit. We've received that Holy Spirit. We have been born again by water and the Holy Spirit through baptism. And many of us watching will have been recipients of the great gifts of the Holy Spirit through the sacrament of confirmation. I think in a particular way of the ninth graders of my own parish here at Holy Family, because today would have been their confirmation day. So I pray in a particular way for the Holy Spirit for them, and it's delayed, not denied. We will have that great celebration. We will get those gifts of the Holy Spirit to you as soon as we can. But that's what gives us a boldness, the power of the Holy Spirit working within us. So let me ask, how many times have you been out and you've been at a restaurant and it's time for the meal has arrived, and if you were at home, you would have made the sign of the cross and prayed, bless us, O Lord, but because you're out in public, you don't. Or maybe you're just kind of little whatever. You don't want to be seen. Is Jesus a secret that you have in your life? Or is Jesus the treasure that you boldly proclaim because he's meant not just to be your treasure, but the treasure for everyone? Now, there's a danger. You know, I can make a big fuss like the Pharisees did about praying in public so everybody goes, oh, what a pious person. We don't want that. But we don't want to hide Jesus's presence. We don't want to hide our discipleship from the world around us. And that's why I think what we need to discover is zeal for souls. Zeal for souls. Not something just for priests. Yes, a priest needs to have zeal for souls. But we all do. And that's what you see even in the lives of the great saints who weren't priests. By their missionary activities, by their works of mercy, by their prayer and sacrifices, they were all seeking, how can I bring souls to Christ? That boldness, that zeal, that's what the Holy Spirit gives us. So let's make sure in this beautiful Easter season, we allow the Holy Spirit to be renewed in the ability to push us out of ourselves, to push us out of respectability, that, you know, in such a secular society, it's not fashionable, it's not popular to speak about Jesus or to pray in public. Let's push past that and give witness. The Lord is risen. Alleluia. Truly, he is risen. Alleluia. Turning to our loving Father, we place before him all of our needs.
For the church, may the people of God live with an ardent hope for heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For lawmakers, may they have the courage to enact laws in accordance with the true good of the human person. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those preparing for marriage, may the grace of Jesus and the intercession of Mary purify their love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all Christians, they be one in faith, hope, and charity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those affected by the coronavirus, may the sick be healed, may the medical personnel be protected, may those affected economically receive the assistance they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they come to share in the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, we ask you to hear these, our prayers, and grant them if they be in accord with your holy will. We ask them as all things through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mysterium fidei.
Mortem tuum annuntiamus Domine, et tuam resurrectionem confitemur. Domine venias.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, Mundi, miser.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Jesus stood in the midst of his disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you. Alleluia." Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Regina Celi, letare, alleluia. Quia que meruisti portare, alleluia. seat. Alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum. Alleluia.
Thank you for joining our live stream of the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass from Holy Family Catholic Church in St. Louis Park, Minnesota. We will conclude today's live stream with our prayers to Mary and St. Michael the Archangel. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all of evil spirits, who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.